हेलो फ्रेंड्स, मेरा नाम सी राजेंद्र अरोड़ा है और दोस्तों जीएसटी में आज हम एक और बड़े इंपॉर्टेंट एंड लेटेस्ट इशू के बारे में बात करेंगे। हम बात करेंगे नोटिफिकेशन 2/2019 सेंट्रल टैक्स रेट के बारे में। फ्रेंड्स, दिस नोटिफिकेशन हैज बीन इशूड अंडर सेक्शन 9 सबसेक्शन 1, 11 सबसेक्शन 1 एंड 16 सबसेक्शन 1। दिस नोटिफिकेशन इज मेड इफेक्टिव फ्रॉम 1 अप्रैल 2019। And the rate of tax, this notification is talking about basically the composition scheme available for small service provider who is involved in provision of supply of services as well as some of the goods also or both. The rate of tax which is prescribed in this notification is 3% each, 3% CGST, 3% SGST. And it would be applied up to the first supplies of goods and services of 50 lakh or less, which are made from 1st April of every year. Now, important question is to understand that what would included and what would not be included in the aggregate turnover. Aggregate, it is specifically in the notification provided that aggregate turnover shall not include the exempt supplies which are made on account of interest received by way of extending deposits and the interest is received as consideration for those. So it means interest income shall not be included in the aggregate turnover for determining the limit of 50 lakh. And one more thing need to be understood, that for determining the limit of 50 lakh, the first 20 lakh for which registration is not required shall be included. It means from 1st April, whatever supply a registered person shall make shall be included to determine the aggregate turnover for calculating the limit of 50 lakh. But for the purpose of calculating the tax payable, those first 20 lakh for which no registration was required to be taken shall not be included. It means for remaining 30 lakh, 6% tax shall be calculated and paid. There are 13 conditions which are required to be met by this particular registered person who opts to this composition scheme available 2/19 central tax rate. First is that the aggregate turnover should be either 50 lakh or less. Second is he is not eligible to claim any composition scheme available under section 10. Then he is not engaged in making any intrastate outward supplies. He is not a casual taxable person or a non-resident taxable person. He is not making any supply of goods and services through e-commerce operator, which e-commerce operator has to collect tax under section 52. Then he is not making supplies of ice creams, pan masala and tobacco products. If he is having more than one registration as distinct person on the same PAN in the country, then this particular composition scheme shall be applied for all such supplies made by registered person from all such registrations. So it means if you have registration in Delhi, Haryana and Punjab, so this composition scheme shall be applied to all those three states, not at Delhi, and Delhi you may opt for composition and two other states you may go for regular scheme. It is not possible. No, you do not have the facility of claiming input tax credit. You cannot collect tax from the recipient. And no, more importantly, you have to write this phrase on the face of the bill of supply which you have to issue. This registered person who is opting composition scheme should issue bill of supply instead of tax invoice. He has to write on the face of the bill of supply that taxable person paying tax in terms of notification number 2/19, 7th central tax rate, 7th March 2019, not eligible to tax collect on supplies. Then even if some other notification is available under section 9 subsection 1, but once this notification is applied, the registered person cannot apply any other notification. And more importantly, this registered person who opts for this composition scheme has to pay tax under reverse charge also on the inward supplies under section 9(3) and 9(4). 9(3) is governed by notification 13/2017 central tax rate, in which 14 Inward supplies are mentioned on which reverse charge is to be paid by the recipient, like this composition supplier. And 9(4) is being amended with effect from 1st February 2019 by way of an Amendment Act 2018, in which that 9(4) has been made live again. But the government has said that they will notify the specific class of persons and specific goods and services on which that 9(4) shall be applicable. It is not yet notified, so 9(4) is not available as yet. It is not applicable as yet, but the moment it would be applicable, it would be applicable to this composition supplier also, who opts for this 2/2019 central tax rate. My dear friends, this is all about the composition scheme of services available for small service provider. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please like our video, subscribe our YouTube channel. Thank you, friends.